from Las Vegas. This week from Hollywood, it's the Merv Griffin Show. Now, here I come.
Well, once again, let me repeat so that you should all know that this Friday night, the First Lady of Television makes her move to a new network in a special with a galaxy of guest stars, and it's called, appropriately enough, Lucy Moves to NBC, and it's airing this Friday at 8:30 p.m. Here she is, Lucille Ball. That's too much love for one human being.
No, it isn't.
That could swarm all over you for a... Huh?
It's very warm and nice.
Isn't it?
You always have a nice audience.
And they love you, Lucy. Wherever you go, every audience is terrific to you. You've never struck out in your life, have you?
Once.
Huh? Want to talk about it?
No.
Oh. What'd you hear? Maybe one little...
No, it's a long story, and I'm not going to tell you until you cook me another meal.
Oh, yeah? Yeah. Anytime you want, Lucy. How are you doing these days? You cooking?
I'm going to be. My help's going to China for 6 weeks, and I'm going to put Gary on a diet.
Are you?
What better time to do it?
Have you ever been a hot one in the kitchen?
There are a lot of things I know how to do that are sort of New England, but not Nate and Al's, you know.
Yeah, yeah. Which room are you best in at home?
Oh, beg your pardon.
Oh, I'm sorry. For asking a thing like that. Do you realize, Lucy, as I read off the list of guest stars here today,
mm-hmm.
We have had a lot of complaints. Not that it's our fault, it just happens in the bookings, of a lot of guest stars who unfortunately have had not successful marriages. Everybody in the show today has had a successful long run.
Yours? I've had two.
I know.
Almost time for me to change again.
Oh, my don't marriage... say that.
I do that. Just to get Gary.
Yeah.
I change husbands every 19 years.
That's really a successful marriage. And it's because you both love to laugh, isn't it?
It helps.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, it helps. Well, this one, I think, is I didn't make the same mistake twice.
Yeah.
You know, a lot of people do that, but...
They marry the same person over again?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah.
No, you married a totally mm-hmm. different fella,
mm-hmm.
didn't you?
Mm-hmm.
Is that the success of the marriage, the humor of it, the fun?
Not really. That certainly helps, but the kind of gentleman that I married is the reason that this one is something.
Yeah.
Yeah. He's a gentle man. He doesn't dig panic, and he doesn't make crises, and he doesn't play games.
No. And slightly sentimental, isn't he?
Very.
Warm heart. You know, I was on the road with him for 6 months. Of course, I saw the performer side of him.
You also saw the playboy side of him, and thank God that's out of his system.
Yeah.
Well, you were very young, all you kids.
I know, but in those days, he was young, and we were traveling to different...
He was young.
Yeah.
You were an old man.
No, but I was getting there. And all he had was his trumpet, you know?
Poor kid.
And nine shows a day... But you know, I never failed to stand backstage and watch Gary perform, because he never did the same act every show. He used to get out there, and when the audience would start to go, Gary would start to go.
Yeah.
He's afraid of it. He's intimidated by nobody, is he?
No, that's true. He'll get up at a dinner party and do the same act. No, he's a happy fellow, and he's an understanding man. He loves his home. And I give him plenty of space to play his golf, and he gives me plenty of space to do what I want to do. And the kids are now up and flying, you know, and everything's all right. We have a lot to be grateful for.
You really do. The kids are just doing incredible. Lucy is starring, as you know, on Broadway, and they're playing our song. She is the most incredible performance. Coached by her mom?
She's a natural, no.
Not at all?
She has always done things that I could never do, and she's done them without training.
And what a voice she's got. Is that same
I don't think her voice is so great, but
it's terrific.
It's a today's type that they buy. It's not a great singing voice. I don't think she would even think that.
How many rehearsals did you go to?
None.
You never walked
in? I didn't even read the script. I know better than that.
How many shows have you gone to?
Ah, I've seen it 3 or 4 times.
Have you ever said to her?
Twice out here and twice in New York.
Have you ever said to her after a show, you missed your laugh in the second scene of the second act?
I think after the third time I had seen the show, I said I thought perhaps something would be better if... I think I did that once or twice, but all 4 times I said to her, do you have to wear that awful wig? And she said, yes. And she's still wearing the damn thing.
Is she?